I'm Team Steve, and I'm drinking this in the name of Captain America. Go, Captain! Yummy.
Hey, this is Team Stark, and I'm drinking this for Iron Man. See this red, yellow, gorgeous concoction? Bottoms up. Delicious!
Should you ever speak up?
Good?
Yes, and I don't care if she's our set girl, puts it up, I don't care.
Okay. Alright, so since we're talking about Civil War, since this is the big thing right now, since people are divided on who was right and who was wrong.
Captain America.
Iron Man. For the sake of conversation, a few months ago I wrote an article.
Hashtag.
On Movie Pilot about someone dying. And that's relevant now because in the comics, the Civil War, the second part of Civil War now, instead of Iron Man versus Captain America, it's Iron Man versus Captain Marvel. And just like you saw in Civil War, spoiler if you haven't seen it, Rhodey gets shot down, but also big for the comics, spoiler alert if you haven't read him yet, he dies in the comic books. You see Iron Man standing over Rhodey's body.
Are they going to kill him, or?
You see Rhodey's body covered in a sheet. You see Rhodey's armor just in shambles. And that was an immediate callback to Civil War, the movie, because they're playing off of the events from the movie and the comic books, because they're so emotional and so, I guess, grandiose in the universe. My biggest point with Civil War is the entire point, the entire focus of the conversation Civil War is government versus private, right?
Exactly.
Okay. That being said, the only reason I think Iron Man was correct in what he was doing was he wants to keep things focused and centralized. Have everything compartmentalized so if it becomes a problem down the line, like there's at least a chain of command to fall on instead of Captain America wanting to just run and gun things. I don't think that's a good way to go, especially with the way the Marvel Cinematic Universe is going out in the future. Like, there are so many other events happening in the universe. With the Guardians of the Galaxy coming, you have,
where you're gonna have, spoiler alert, you're gonna be having Black Panther.
Yes.
Which, I think they did a phenomenal job in the movie. And then we're gonna also have Spider-Man.
Chadwick Boseman did an amazing job.
I was actually very surprised.
Yes, I was very happy.
And I like that they're not going to be touching on the Uncle Ben situation that's happened.
Thank God. If I have to hear one more damn Uncle Ben story, I will lose my mind. If I have to walk through Kroger again, or Food Lion, or wherever
we go
to buy
groceries. I was going to say, the rice stock is going to go down.
Uncle Ben food box, and think of the crying old man from the first Spider-Man movies with 40-year-old baby-faced Tobey Maguire, who I couldn't stand in the first Spider-Man movie. I hated the first three ones.
I like the Amazing.
I thought Andrew Garfield was a phenomenal Spider-Man.
Yes.
I saw nothing wrong with it. Okay.
The script could have been
the
better.
The writing was a little wacky. Not going to deny that whatsoever.
But Garfield was much better than Maguire.
Yes. And I do think that they found a perfect mix of young and experienced and cynical in Tom Holland. Like, the little bit we saw of him and Civil War was great.
I actually hope that they touch on the way Stark helps him.
Yes.
And kind of progresses. And I think, as Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. has shown, it kind of has given us a bit of, what's the word, visualization on what young geniuses can do. And it
yes.
does work.
Yes.
It will work. And if they focus on that, the two of them working together, and less on a love story, because the love story kind of takes it out of whack.
Yeah.
That's another thing that kind of, the Maguire ones.
I really do not want to see Spider-Man trying to get his dick weighed again. I don't want to see that. I didn't care about it the first time. I could not stand I couldn't stand Mary Jane.
No.
I liked, Gwen Stacy?
Okay, I better not have said you liked Dunst.
I liked it, but I thought it was really out of place for the movie.
It was cheesy. Just go with it. They were cheesy.
And I'm probably one of the few people who thought this, but when she smacked her head off the ground and died on impact, I was like, yes, she's dead, thank God! Yes! She was so annoying.
I watched a movie yesterday.
Yeah.
And since we're not talking, it's not Marvel. I'm not going to get into it too much, except for I really want the love interest to just go away.
Yes.
I understand. Love interests have to be there. They're necessary. Like, as we're going to discuss, Jessica Jones.
Yes.
That is more of a love interest than I would rather see.
Yeah. And even that, I was kind of put off by the way they approached it. Like, they still approached it as it being a taboo subject. And I think if you focus more on the details of a relationship, you lose a lot of the context of the relationship. So, like, them both being superpower humans, you know? Like, they touched on that a lot, which we already knew that. We could tell that that was already a thing. So they didn't have to keep joking about it.
But they didn't... Also, they didn't focus on that being the main topic of Jessica Jones. How many episodes... He was not there, correct?
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, there was maybe 3 or 4 he was completely not in. They focused on her.
Yes.
I think, in my opinion, Jessica Jones has done so well.
Yes.
It has done... It's totally... Totally. A feminist dream.
Totally. Hashtag, hashtag. If you have not seen Jessica Jones, do so. There's going to be a second season coming out sometime soon. You need to catch up. It is a phenomenal TV show to watch. It's on Netflix.
It is.
You need to watch it.
It's dark.
As soon as possible.
It is dark. It goes along with the whole... Because it came on... Daredevil is also on Netflix.
Yes.
And I watched Daredevil. It's good. But second season brings out quite a few characters that I'm completely looking forward to.
The first season of Daredevil, I was really surprised at how well it was directed, how well the script is.
Fisk was really, I mean...
I didn't like Wilson Fisk.
But he gets into the character, you know, the actor.
Okay.
If you've seen anything
yes.
that he's in, he
yes.
kind of gets into it.
Vincent, as an actor, everything I've seen him in, I have been in love with. But the character Wilson Fisk...
Oh, no, not the character, but...
In the universe of Daredevil, this Daredevil on Netflix, I didn't
appreciate. I think they focused a little too much on it.
Yeah, they focused too much on a villain's growth.
Drawn
and
out.
Don't care.
It was honestly drawn out.
Yes.
Well,
once again with the love story. Once again with that.
Yes.
I don't care about some...
No. And I kind of like the whole foggy love story because it's just not there enough. I'm just saying, it touches on it just enough.
Foggy can go hang himself for all I care about.
I know, you're not.
There are so many unnecessary characters in the things Marvel puts out, but they have a good way, in the movies at least, of detracting from what's unnecessary and only bringing in what they need to at a certain point.
Right.
Whereas the TV shows, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., they focus on a lot of subplot growth.
And if
because
you
over...
don't like S.H.I.E.L.D., I'm sorry. I know it's time to catch up. I watch S.H.I.E.L.D. because it helps me out.
Yeah.
It helps me understand how the cinematic universe is going
yes.
to continue on. Seriously, if you don't know anything about it,
yeah.
if you were going in straight, no comic books, no characters, you're going to have to get that. And it goes right in with the movies.
From a non comic book lover's perspective, S.H.I.E.L.D. is like the Cliff Notes
yes.
version of things. And they do a really good job with establishing themselves as a separate entity that's connected to everything else. But as a TV show, when it's supposed to be entertaining, I literally find myself falling asleep on the controller. I'm just like...
But it's one of those necessary things that you have... Okay, they just mentioned this. This was a hint to what's about to happen because I've been watching it,
yeah.
I guess, live. DVR live doesn't happen anymore. But I've been watching it and I'm like... I watched Civil War, and I'm like, shit, they just told me
yep.
what was about to happen. And
yep.
then the next episode was after Civil War, and they referenced it.
Yeah.
And I think that's the whole point, is it keeps you connected.
Yeah.
And that is, it's the glue, in a way, for the person, so Marvel is never gone.
Yeah.
And that is their goal. And that's why they're successful.
I mean, I love S.H.I.E.L.D. for what they're trying to do. And I haven't watched S.H.I.E.L.D. in, like, 2 seasons.
I just think Marvel, what they're doing is... Great.
Yes, but I want Marvel to end S.H.I.E.L.D. for one reason. Marvel will always be the king of movies, as far as comic goes. Always.
Yeah.
They need to focus on building their strong suit, which is the Marvel Cinematic Universe. The TV shows, they need to drop it now, they need to get Coulson off this damn screen, get him back on movies.
They've already reanimated him so he can come back to the movies.
Tahiti is a magical place.
He can have his bromance with Thor.
Yes.
What?
No, it was with Wasn't it with Cap, though? And it's
no, it was Cap, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was Cap.
It was Cap. Because he had the trading cards.
In the Avengers, he was just like, oh my god, there's Cap.
But then he died right after, and you're like, tearing up.
Yeah, when Coulson died, I was just like, bro, you can't kill Coulson! He was the one person who didn't belong there who found a reason to be there. And can we please just murder Agent Hill? Can we just kill her? Can we just, like, have Thor's hammer just, like, get flown across the base, smack her in the head, and kill her? Just give her the most gruesome but entertaining death in all of cinematic history. I'm not kidding about this. I guarantee you, in one or two movies, Agent Hill will be dead. Well, I'm hoping and praying.
They've already gotten rid of Carter.
Yeah!
They got rid of the TV show.
That's one show I didn't get to catch up on, and I'm mad about that.
Honestly, I thought that S.H.I.E.L.D. would have done better if they merged Carter with S.H.I.E.L.D. and had a few episodes being Carter and a few S.H.I.E.L.D. because the two of them separate aren't as strong.
The only thing I think they could have done better with Carter and S.H.I.E.L.D. is if they did more of a backstory in Carter on how S.H.I.E.L.D. came to be the way it is now with her help and Stark's help. Because they were finally.
She was important. I understand she was a very important character. I just was one of the few people that I really didn't want to watch the show.
I mean, her acting, the little we saw in the first Avenger.
I just don't like the era.
I thought it was kind of cardboard. Okay, that's an entirely different topic of conversation. That's something I don't want to talk about right now. you're just plain wrong on that one. In the first Avenger, we saw her and Steve like having this kind of blooming romance, whatever you want to call it. I don't care. And as a callback to that, and so was it Civil War? It was the second Cap movie. Like he's trying to like just cope with how things are now, and he's trying to like.
The second one was the one where he found her when she was older.
Yeah, exactly.
But that's also when he met Agent 13.
Yeah.
And that kind of is a bittersweet transition.
Yeah, and it was so weird when he's sitting there hitting on the love of his life's relative. It's like, bro, no.
But
it was so wrong.
But it was at the funeral.
Yeah, exactly. That is the weirdest time you could have ever picked to hit on someone aside from their wedding. Their relative who you were in love with is dead. So you're hitting on this person now.
Well, Marvel is saying it was going to happen, that they were going to have a romance, and they figured that was probably the best one to go right now.
Like, that just gives you an insight on how weird and crazy Marvel is. Yeah, she's dead. She's related. Let's have Cap hit on her.
But then if you think about it, Cap, I mean, as old as Carter was, their romance, it was more just a love that was in memoriam, in a way.
That's true.
So that love itself was already dying, and it was more of a respect.
See, I think the biggest joke in the Marvel movies to date was when Bucky was talking to Cap about something, and Cap was like, you're like 100 years old, aren't you?
Yeah.
Like, see, he recognizes that he's hitting on someone who was literally a quarter of his age.
Well, I mean, they both represent, aren't you the same?
It's like, you're 100 years old. You are physically 100 or more years old. She's like 35.
But that is one of the things that I like about the whole Captain and Bucky friendship.
Yeah.
Is that through all of this, they've always stayed the exact same thing as they were in the foxhole.
Yeah.
Right?
See, I think, okay, going back to the topic at hand, Civil War, Cap versus Iron Man. I mean, versus Cap, whatever you want to call it. I do think this was a big analogy for Iron Man getting out of the cave in the first movie. But, like, there's a conflict. He's trying to find a way to build his way out of it. So what's he do? He builds an alliance with these guys up here to fight his way out of it.
Right.
But instead, it literally backfires on him. He ends up imprisoning his friends at the end of the movie.
And that's, honestly, that's kind of, I'm very big on loyalty and friendship. And I think Stark, they switched places. Think about it. With Captain America, he was always loyal to the government. He did what he was supposed to do.
Yeah.
He did everything. He went by the book.
Yeah.
He did not deviate. Then he gets with the Avengers.
Yep.
And they get there, And now he feels his loyalty is to them because, as I have said, the government has failed him. S.H.I.E.L.D. is fault. No one is there to give orders because their orders kind of turned that mess.
Yep.
They made it happen.
See, my biggest confusion about Hydra and Civil War and Cap and Iron Man is in the Avengers, Stark puts little chips everywhere to scan everything that S.H.I.E.L.D. knows.
Mm-hmm.
He should have found all this stuff out back then. Period. Unless all their data was in somewhere else. And even for Marvel, that's kind of like an out-of-the-box scheme for them to concoct. I understand that it's a cinematic universe, that it's a comic book movie, so there's some sort of suspension disbelief. That I understand. But it's still Tony Stark, who's one of the richest men in the world, who can get anything he wants any time of the day just by stabbing his fingers with Jarvis.
Right. But I think he was afraid of his own power.
That's true. Yeah, because you saw in Iron Man 3 when he was, like, losing his mind going...
He caused all of that.
Yeah.
And what happens in Civil War, it's his conscience.
Yep.
It is all, I can't do this again. I just cannot. And in a way, it's kind of self-serving. In my opinion, it is self-serving him going to this, an organization that we have found out that, well, Hydra can get in, under, in anything.
Yep.
But if you go by strict orders, they're going to tell you, no, you can't do that because that's going to cause damage. You're going to want to save that person. You're going to want to do something.
Yeah.
And they're going to say no. But as a superhero, you want to do it.
You feel the need to want to get in between.
And that's why Cap is as passionate as he is, because he knows what's right.
Yeah, see, like, even with that, there's fault in an argument. Even with that, there's things I don't agree with Cap with. Like, Cap has seen both sides of war.
Yes.
He's been on the front and he's been on the offensive. Mm-hmm. Like, he is a war hero. There's no denying that. Stark is not a war hero. He was a civilian who got mixed in there.
I was going to say, considering the very first Iron Man, he's selling off stuff to
the bad
guys.
So he was just a salesman, basically.
Yes.
And then he just kind of got screwed into everything else. So he's on the outside looking in. He's seeing what's wrong with everything. He's trying to fix it from the outside, but then gets kind of thrust into it with crap in his chest. You know? So, that being said, I really think that Stark was in the right on this one. Like, there needs to be more control. There needs to be more focus on keeping things in line.
But it's going to go to the extreme because someone else is going to have the control.
Okay. Okay.
I'm a natural rebel, so I don't like taking orders.
I understand that. Let's go back to Avengers for a second, because you saw the council on those big screens.
Yes.
When she was talking to them, right?
Mm-hmm.
But that same council in Winter Soldier, like, they were basically taken out with S.H.I.E.L.D.
Right. It's a S.H.I.E.L.D. just S.H.I.E.L.D.
Yeah. S.H.I.E.L.D.'s gone.
Yes.
Like, the things that they stood for was taken out. So they have a chance to make things new, make things better, make things more constructive, now that the entire base of operations has been destroyed.
But then you have the show, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., they're bringing the Inhumans in.
Yeah. And that's going to make such a big mess of everything. Okay, okay.
But it's all about controlling they're doing the exact same thing.
The basis of Civil War in the comics, it was the Sanford incident. And it was a school that was nuked because of superpowered people getting in the way.
Right.
They caused a lot of damage. They killed kids. And that's apparently a big no-no wherever you are, whatever universe you live in, comics or not.
You're not killing kids. You don't kill dogs. Although they're...
Kill the dogs!
Yes, kill the dogs!
They poop in my yard, they cross the street, I almost hit them. If your dog crosses my street and I'm driving, I'm hitting it. Keep it on the leash. All
right. Now, there is a TV show that I watched, zombie-related, completely awesome, because the very first episode, Zombie Baby. Zombie Baby takes out who you think is the main character.
The hell is this show you're talking about?
It's on Sci-Fi.
Who watches Sci-Fi?
Z Nation. I watch Sci-Fi, or Sci-Fi. NBC took it over. Actually, they're starting to come out with a lot of good shows right now. They're going back to Space Kids, but I know you're not into sci-fi as much as I am.
It's just okay. Let's refocus. Let's get away from Sippy and their stupid nonsense movies and their stupid. Just stop.
I'm just sci-fi, saying.
Sci-fi. You need to get better writers. I understand that you're like this.
They're doing it.
Let me finish. Sci-fi. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you and your shitty little scripts. You need to be better. Okay.
It's NBC's fault.
You need to be better. NBC. You need to stop too. You're messing up, and we notice. That's why your ratings are dropping. #. Okay.
Back to Marvel.
Back to the Stanford incident. So with Civil War, they substituted the UN bombing for the Stanford incident.
Right.
And as we know, it was all just one big plot by a German.
Okay. And his reasoning is because he was hurt.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
But that is his whole purpose for what he is doing.
Because he was butthurt.
He was butthurt. He lost his family. I'm going to make you pay.
He was an internet troll who got his ass kicked. Woo.
Basically. And he comes in. And he goes in, I am going to split up your family like I split up my family. And he succeeds.
Yeah,
he succeeds. Massively succeeds
he plays
in splitting them up.
One huge mind game with the Avengers and wins because these two idiots couldn't sit down and talk about things. And
the whole bringing up the past.
In the comics, they play on that too because Iron Man and Captain America, they talk about things. Iron Man is like, look, man. I won't talk about this. We know how it plays out already. Like, they call a lot of the movies in the... So spoilers, spoiler alert.
We've been spoiling
when
this since the beginning.
Read the comic books. Make sure you have seen this, because it plays into it. There's a lot of focus on these events in the new comics. So don't be upset when Matt spoiled the comics for you, because I'm warning you.
I am
warning you.
It gets darker, too.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, this is, baby.
Yeah.
It gets
darker. This stuff is like marshmallow fluff on a cupcake. You understand? It's light, it's comfortable, it's fluffy, but the comic's coming out, it's like chocolate in a mud puddle. It's dark, it's gross, it gets everywhere, it's nasty, it gets violent.
Your moral convictions are really going to be fucked up when you kind of...
Language. Kids. See? That's what you get on Capside! That's what you get! They break all the rules. We said no language, no swearing, because this is for kids and our friends.
I believe
friends,
you already
family.
Done that.
I did not say the F word.
Okay, fair enough.
I did not say the F word, and you can't even say the F word on TV. So, boom.
So we're cutting that out.
Yes, that's going to be edited, maybe.
Do you know how to bleep?
Yes.
Then
okay.
Bleep it.
Okay, so the one. Before we get too sidetracked with this stuff, I want to bring up one more important piece of information from Civil War. It's not super important, at least for other people, but to me, this was a huge thing. At least, well, not Civil War, it was from...
Ultron?
Week of Ultron. Age of Ultron is nonsense.
That was... Yeah.
It was no more than a week period. No more than just a week. It was like Sunday, thinking about it. Monday, he's made. Tuesday, he's like in Sokovia. Wednesday, they're like flying there. Thursday, they make Vision. Friday, they're fighting. Saturday, recuperating. It was a week. Okay.
I think everybody can agree. Completely agree. Ultron itself.
Okay, the movie itself to me was terrible.
No, the storyline, the movie, everything. I mean, but it had to happen because it was a lead up to
everything
that's going on. So it's kind of one of those necessary things.
It was a necessary evil.
Not as bad as the necessary shield, but it's there.
Yes. Okay. Quicksilver dying. I wasn't even mad about Quicksilver dying. I was kind of relieved it happened finally, because the Quicksilver in Avengers, like, he was... He was just an idiot, in my opinion. He was doing all the right things just because his sister was telling him to, basically. And I didn't like Scarlet Witch.
You don't like the Scarlet Witch. I actually like the way they did her.
I didn't like Scarlet Witch and Age of Ultron.
Okay, in Civil War...
In Civil War, I thought
she
was fantastic.
Phenomenal.
No problem with her there.
And I'm actually hearing complaints. People are complaining about... what she's wearing in the TV as opposed to the comics.
Who cares?
Really? Seriously.
Who cares? The things that you... Okay.
Yeah, no, seriously.
The costumes you saw in the comic books, they wouldn't fly in real life.
They literally would not fly. I mean, you try to stick them on, it's worse than pasties.
the things they wore in comic books, the latex, the like neon colored spandex. If I saw one person walk on the street with some neon yellow boots and spandex on, I would have them committed. I don't care. I don't care.
There's
what
places
you can
for that.
Do. I don't care. You can fly a million miles a second. If I see you wearing those ugly boots and those spandex, you're getting committed.
Honestly, if you have your underwear on the outside, I'm not going to take you seriously.
You need pills. If you are an adult and you are wearing underwear on the outside of your jeans like a quail man from Doug, you need to go home and change. If you're an adult, you act like it.
Unless you're Aquaman, but that's a different topic.
DC, you're next.
Yes.
I got some things to say about you, DC. You're coming up next.
Oh, so many things to say.
So many feels. Major feels. Major.
Majors. They're mad.
Iron Man. Captain America.
Why are they mad?
Why are they mad?
We're doing this whole thing. Give the ultimate reason. And it honestly is, it boils down to the very end. Why do they actually physically fight? They fight because...
they have massive egos.
Well, they do have massive egos. That's true. But Steve had information about Stark's parents.
Yes.
That he
yes.
didn't know until Bucky brought it up.
Yes. Yes, that's right.
So, that's what caused their literal fight. Before then, it was... he knew something was wrong.
Yep.
Stark knew something was wrong. And Steve didn't think about it because he was trying to protect his friend's feelings.
Yep.
And it was very symbolic when he threw the shield.
Yep.
He threw the shield after Stark said, "That belongs to me."
Because it did.
It did.
His dad made it.
It. And the whole thing is, he gave his shield back and he basically said, "We're done. I'm done with you. We have separated.
Yep.
We can't do this together." And
gotta
that
say,
was their rift.
That whole scene was in the trailer. He's my friend. I was too. Lay down. Try not to cry. Cry a lot. It's like you see your two favorite characters on screen breaking their friendship. I was kind of thrown out by that. That got me deep.
It was very emotional to watch.
But honestly, okay. This guy here killed your parents. This guy here knows about it. Not until the last minute, though. And then he's just like, yeah. He killed your parents. Like, I fight about that too!
But the Winter Soldier.
Winter Soldier.
No. We're going to go on about this because why? The Winter Soldier and Bucky, they're two separate people.
They're two separate psychological people.
Bruce Banner, Hulk.
I'd have them both killed.
But
I don't care if it's team
so is how is the Hulk acceptable?
It's not acceptable.
They let it I think that's the reason why he's not in this movie, because it would confuse people. Why is Banner running around doing this? The only thing that basically can calm him down is Black Widow.
Yeah.
So
this stupid little hand gesture. I'll give you a hand gesture.
But he
anger you.
He can turn into the Hulk like that.
Yeah, okay.
But then Winter Soldier takes how much? You have to activate him.
Yeah.
So he's actually more controllable the whole time. He is not in control of anything. And what he does at the end, when he puts himself to sleep, ice, whatever it is that he's doing, he's doing it because he wants to do it. He thinks it is what's best for humankind.
But I still don't think that there is not a comparison between Winter Soldier and the Hulk. Like, yeah, like, they have a lot of things alike, because one can be controlled, one can't, one just rages out and destroys things, one you have to say words to get them to kill people, whatever. It's still the same issue. If you have a person who can be activated for a certain effect, they need to be taken out of the game.
Okay.
That's why Hulk was blasted off into space. For Thor Ragnarok, spoiler alert, they're doing Planet Hulk, just so you know. You need to read up on that, too.
But in Civil War, all they talk about, well, he's off doing something somewhere. I mean,
yeah.
They're very...
it's not important for what we're talking about now, basically. It's not important.
But that's how they got him out of the story, so you would focus on Bucky and Winter Soldier, not get confused. Because, personally, I think that there is a very close similarity, and if they had the Hulk in, you would have a lot of back and forth with people in the audience.
That's true. I understand that. But what I'm saying is... dude's a super soldier assassin, right?
Yes.
Right? Okay. That we agree on. He killed Stark's parents for things that would make more of him. thereby making the things that the German was trying to get back to.
Right.
So it's one circle of events repeating on themselves.
As you found out, he really was only using it to get the two of them together to fight for the exact purpose.
I understand that, but for the purpose of the story development, let's just go
down
the
line. Okay, we go on development.
Let's go on the line. In the beginning, Stark's parents were going away to deliver this serum to Place X, right?
Right.
Okay. When the soldier intercepts them, knocks the car off the road, like shoots a tire or something, they hit a pole, he makes it look like they killed themselves in a car accident.
Yes, and then he...
And then he takes the box out of the trunk, drives off.
Right.
Years later, the events unfold, we find out that Bucky was the one who assassinated them because of surveillance footage. Right?
Yeah.
Okay, so, cause and effect there. German group. Winter Soldier. Parents' death. German group. Infiltrator. Assassin dude. Causes all the stuff to be brought into the air, thereby splitting up the Avengers, causing this, basically this entire conflict because of that one event 20-some years ago.
Right.
So, if that would have been put out years ago, none of the organizations today would have been built anyway.
Correct. It kind of was the start of everything because of Stark had not had that drive.
Yep.
And that's basically what it comes to. It was the death of his parents was the birth of him.
Yep. I just think that even with everything else being said about this and Civil War and Bucky and Cap and Iron Man, I think Bucky needs to be taken out of the game permanently. I think the Hulk does as well. Even though he's going to be out with Thor.
He's actually going to be very, very... I think that's a better place for him.
Yeah, he's going to be out on his own movies for the next one, for Thor 3 Ragnarok.
Yeah, because gods are so controllable, right?
Yeah, exactly. Like, you have these metaphysical beings, basically, like, doing literally whatever they want to. They can go between worlds. Like, you have Thanos, who, like, has a gauntlet, which I forgot to bring with me, who will have all of the gems soon.
Not prepared.
Even though... Shut up, Illidan. Warcraft, you're next, too. I swear to God, you let me down. Legion, the expansion, comes out this fall. If you let me down, I'm done.
I've actually got that on our website. We're working on that, and it's got what we're looking forward to, and Legion is on there.
I swear to God, Legion, if you let me down, I'm disbanding my guild, I'm selling my account, I'm done. I'm selling all my collectibles. Blizzard, you let me down, I'm done. Overwatch is okay, you got me for a couple of months, but Legion, you let me down, you're done.
I'm looking forward to the movie.
Oh, I am too. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm really
passionate. He spoiled what we're going to be talking about, but you know what? Oh, well.
Okay. Update. Anything you want for scheduling, for personal biographies, for our Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, all going to be in the links below. We have everything we're going to be talking about in the next couple of months, roughly.
We're definitely up for interaction.
Yeah.
We love interaction.
If you want us to talk about something, post it. Tweet it, hashtag it, whatever you want to do.
Hashtag. That's going to get our attention, is hashtag.
Hashtag. Oh my God. If you want to talk about something.
The brainchild of Matt is hashtag.
If you want something to discuss on this show, feel free. And if it gets enough likes, we'll build an entire set piece with your comment, like, in a frame, just so you know that you're the one who started the chain of events.
Exactly.
Just like Bucky, you should be dead. He should be dead.
Bucky did exactly what he needed. He's asleep.
Bucky doesn't know.
Bucky doesn't know what?
Bucky doesn't know. Oh. So don't tell Tony. Bucky doesn't know. Bucky doesn't know. What?
It's time for the hat.
You know what? Give me the hat.
It's time for the hat.
You've done it. It's because I can't stay on topic, so I get to wear the full set.
You've done it.
I mean, it works for me because my hair's a mess, so I get to wear that.
Oh, look! Iron Man's eye.
Whatever.
We are called fools. So, anyway, back on topic.
Team Iron Man.
Captain America.
Team Iron Man.
Captain
okay.
America!
We let. Oh my God. Major feels. We left off talking about how Bucky should be put out to death. And
this isn't really about Bucky.
It is about Bucky. The entire movie is about Bucky being an asshole.
It is about Bucky, but we dealt with that Winter Soldier. That was more about Bucky. This is about Cap and Tony. It really is about Cap and Tony.
Yeah. It is.
Bucky is just kind of the driving point. You know, my gestures work real well right there. I apologize.
No, she doesn't.
For the staff.
What staff?
That's laughing in the background.
Oh, I thought you meant like a Warcraft staff. That's where my brain went.
Dude, no, Gandalf.
Which Gandalf?
The gray. He's a little bit more
That's
rough
racist.
And tumbled. Alright.
You're talking about Bucky.
No, I was saying
since you're so caught up Bucky's arm.
I'm caught up. I said we need to get off of Bucky because we need to focus on them. Now we're talking Civil War at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
I think we pretty much touch on most of the subjects. We've touched on why Iron Man was correct, and yep. I get it. I do understand. He needs everything organized. He needs to not have a chaotic mess happen.
Yes.
But he went about it in the way that everybody does. Let's put a committee together that's going to run our lives, because that works so well in every government system.
I do not think that was the intention. I think the way we perceived it... Hold on. Let me
okay.
think. I think the way we perceived it was not what Marvel had planned. Because they're making a war console out of it, from what I got.
Yeah, it's exactly how I saw it.
Yeah, okay. They're bringing these different parts of government together
mm-hmm.
to dictate who goes where for what, right?
Yes.
War Council. Like, there's going to be some intervention for those who signed up to go to different places.
Right.
Like, that's going to happen. But I don't think the way the general public is perceiving it is how it was stated. And I'm totally okay with this War Council, because it means that if Iron Man goes, like, I don't know, to Wakanda to fight Black Panther, it's going to be for a good reason. And Iron Man already wants to punch half of the world anyway, just because he's angry about Bucky killing his parents. So he's in the perfect state of mind to be a weapon of mass destruction.
He's in the perfect state of mind to go crazy and tear some crap up.
I am totally ready for Tony Stark to just lose his mind. We saw him in 3, just like this far into a bottle, just losing his mind. Talking to a kid in the garage about building spare parts out of nothing. Like, Tony starts losing it, and I'm really excited for him to just go off.
Yeah, but then you got the whole, I'm kind of glad of Civil War Pepper. Whatever. That fuels a little bit of his anger, too.
Yeah. I'm kind of glad she's gone, too, though.
Oh, yeah.
I'm really just glad, like, they're just filtering out chicks. No offense. Filtering out these love interests
yes,
from these movies.
Yes, thank you for the love interests, because the ones that are fighting, like Scarlet Witch,
yep.
Black Widow... They need to be out
yep.
there. They're
can
actually
we, Can we
what?
Please just send Hawkeye home? Please? He just wants to go home. He's a guy with a bow and arrow. Like he said in Age of Ultron. Like, do you know how crazy this is?
He's the most human out of all. I think that's why they have him, to remind us.
What about Black Widow?
I want to know so much more about her.
Well, you have the internet.
No.
Go to Reddit! Reddit! Reddit, I'm counting on you. Fill this person in with everything she's over. Reddit. That's your job.
He actually has to create a Reddit account, because I've never been on it.
I have a Reddit account, my own personal one. If you see me posting my Reddit...
So if you see a picture of me duct taped to a chair, it's because he's forcing me to read Reddit.
It was one time, she was drunk, there was a midget involved, I'm sorry. Internet, I am sorry if you find the midget picture.
I want to see this midget picture!
It was
if you find a hashtag midget picture.
Hashtag midget picture. I'm sorry, internet. I'm sorry. And send Hawkeye home. He has a wife. He has kids. He has this amazing farmhouse. You see that barn he had? Dude, I want to live in that house.
But he is loyal.
Exactly.
And he's doing it because he wants to help his friend.
But go home, bro.
Well,
you're
he kind of sort of can't right now because he's in
a
cell.
You're a dude.
Or, well, no, he got let out.
You're a dude wearing purple leather. Fighting next to a dude who is...
What is wrong with... First of all, what's wrong...
Nothing is wrong with purple. I'm just stating the fact that it itself is purple. That's it.
I was gonna say, purple, dude, it's fine. Prince wore it well.
I have purple silk underwear, so there's that.
Have to take someone else's word for that.
Yeah, take my word for it, that and the midget picture. I'm sorry. Just, if you don't have powers, stay the hell home. You're gonna get yourself killed. Okay? It's just like Jessica Jones. She can do things. She can jump. She can punch someone's penis through their butt. And it's gone.
Such a tiny little thing has so much power. I love it. I do. I love it.
You mean a hat or a penis? Because I just made a penis joke.
And Jessica Jones!
See?
See, I went for the Jessica Jones part. He went directly to the crotch. You see where this goes?
Well, I was talking about Jessica Jones punching a penis through a butt.
But you mentioned Jessica Jones, and I thought about her. I love Jessica Jones.
Okay, anyway.
But that's so we're kind of doing...
Also, okay, while we're talking about Jessica Jones and Netflix and TV stuff, I love the fact that they mention the Marvel Cinematic Universe, but don't mention people by name because they legally can't.
But you know exactly what they're talking
about. Hilarious. Yeah, the battle over there happened, blah, 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 whatever ago, or like
the big green guy.
What's up? See that synergy? That's how babies are made. Oh, that and midget pictures.
Midget pictures.
What a time to be alive.
So, I know we pointed on Civil War. We've had a massive discussion regarding that.
Yep.
I'm pretty firm. I mean, I understand both sides.
Can somebody please, like, set a counter for when she says massive? I think that's like 6 times now.
Are you feeling a little, no?
What?
It's like not so massive?
No.
Every time I say massive, it makes you feel smaller.
Like she just has like a list that she has, a word list she has to just like cross off like every.
Well, you told me I couldn't say F words because I will throw the F bomb everywhere otherwise.
I mean, you can say the F word. I'm just not
gonna gonna be completely bleeped
I'm
out.
I'm just not gonna spend like an entire segment of it of a show just like beep 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 beep.
But anybody that knows me knows that that's going to
happen.
This
isn't Deadpool. I can't spend an entire... Deadpool!
The years of my god, Deadpool!
Let's talk about Deadpool for a minute. I waited so long to see Deadpool on screen. I waited so long to see this movie. To see Ryan Reynolds just destroy this movie. It was phenomenal. Both the marketing for the movie... The actual movie, the cast of the movie, like, they knock this movie out of the park. And for every one of you parents who took your underage child to see this movie, you should have your child taken from you.
The best idea, I think, if you want your kid to see it. As the staff has done. I have not allowed staff. Now.
Have you seen Deadpool?
No.
Do you know... Why you have not seen Deadpool? Tell the camera why you have not seen Deadpool.
Because of what's in it and the rating.
Aside from the rating, it's very inappropriate for someone your age, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Wildly inappropriate.
And you're okay with that? You understand that?
Mm-hmm.
That's it. Staff, go. Bye.
Understand that it is June now, and this came out back in February.
That's why we're talking.
That means you've had 4 months to avoid your children from seeing this movie. And if your kid who is under 17 has seen this movie and you let them, you're messing up.
Lock it up in the cabinet with the other videos they're not supposed to see.
Yeah, because I'm sure some of you guys have movies your kids can't watch because they're inappropriate. And I bet the same people who took their kids to see Deadpool are the same parents who bought GTA 5 for them. You're messing up. You need to think about your life.
I'm so glad I have not played that.
Don't. If you haven't played GTA 5 or Warcraft, don't. They will steal your souls and you won't give them back. Blizzard, you're messing up.
Fair enough. Naughty dog. But anyway, another... You can take the hat off now. We're kind of going everywhere.
Bum, bum, bum! I am Fro-Man the Barbarian. Let me get my hat.
Oh no, the hat. He's fallen.
I am Fro-Man.
You are Fro-Man.
I just want to, like, knock it down just to pick it up again.
The staff did such a good job.
We don't pay her enough. We don't pay her. It's child labor laws. She's been working for like 20 minutes. I think we need to pay her something. If I had candy bar, I'd give it to her, but... I'm not giving her my watch. My dad gave me his watch.
I need to know.
Oh. 3 o'clock.
Okay.
It's the final countdown! Okay. So, we talked about Civil War. We talked about how Cap is messing up.
So, I think we've done our job in our explanation of why we think Civil War, the side we've chosen and why.
Yep.
That was the whole point of why you came to see us.
Yep. If you think Iron Man was right, make sure to comment below, type #, or, you know, just be normal and type #.
Wait a minute. You need to show them what they need to hashtag. Good.
I should do that.
Show them.
Don't worry, I'll bring them to the camera so you can see it with your own peepers.
We got staff for that.
I'll do it myself. It's my hashtag.
Well then.
Tell me I live my life. Staff, give me a black marker. I feel like we should be talking to her by name.
Hi.
No, we can't because that's DC Universe.
Oh, that's right.
We're doing Marvel. Which I think I get points for that, by the way.
If you think Iron Man was right, comment below. #. Or just, you know, Team Iron Man, because that would be the normal thing to do, but... You know,
we want to see #, just because Matt thinks it's going to be a thing. Let's bring it out.
Put it over everything.
Make Matt feel better.
I don't feel bad
about it. He feels inadequate.
No, I don't.
I say massive too much, and I make him feel tiny.
I feel inadequate.
He is not Ant-Man.
Okay, for the record, Ant-Man...
Ant-Man's gigantic.
Paul Rudd was the biggest part of that movie.
Yes, he's...
And that was a short
joke. Where is he? Over here. I have Ant-Man. I love... Ant-Man is my favorite of the whole Marvel thing.
Because she has a tiny brain.
It's better than a tiny something else.
Tiny cancer cell count?
Yeah, we'll go with that.
See, look! Yeah! I turned a negative into a positive.
No, because he took my dirty words away! He took my dirty words away. We're going to put Ant-Man right here, because Ant-Man is super fabulous.
Ice is cold in your teeth. Don't be like me. I think I just froze my tooth. Okay. Alright, so. Recap. Iron Man's right. Cap is wrong.
Really?
Just, you know, human.
He hasn't learned his lesson yet.
I'm not going to learn my lesson
Captain's yet. Right. Iron Man is wrong.
Moving on.
We are going on from our discussion with Captain America.
Yep.
And Iron Man, and I think we're going to broaden a little bit. You heard a little bit of us talking about Marvel. This is Marvel Cinematic Universe.
Yes.
What? You need to make sure you say that because our lovely staff did that for us. To let you know.
Marvel.
Just in case.
Cinematic
Universe. And it is a little bit different.
If I was fancy, I'd have that like in like big cascading words, but...
Our budget is...
Our budget is like 32K a year.
Our budget is as big as his butthole.
And that's like tiny. That's like Ant-Man the nucleus level tiny. So pooping is really hard for me sometimes. So please, donate.
Don't make him make the face.
Donate. We can make a Patreon so we can like give me some laxatives so I can go home and poop safely. Because it's been a struggle. Because
everybody
just
poops.
Don't know how hard it is for me. To go to the bathroom and use really rough toilet paper. I have sensitive skin. I need my Charmin. I need my triple black toilet paper. Alright. What's up, dog? You guys are crazy. You guys.
We're crazy.
I have problems.
We're crazy.
Right?
That's it.
It's
I'm
hard for me to work things out, so
be...
I'm kind of backed up emotionally.
Yeah. The outlet. Perfect outlet.
Pooping.
Marvel Cinematic Universe.
What about it?
We were going to discuss. We got, in Civil War, we were introduced to Black Panther.
Yes. Black Panther is not to be confused with the political group of Black Panther.
Totally different.
The superhero came before the group, just so you're aware of that. Just so you know.
I think that they did well with their subtleties.
That's a true fact. Wikipedia that.
Well, yeah. Comics have been around for forever.
I know. I'm just saying. Kids. Whatever. Who's excited for Doctor Strange? I am.
I am completely excited for Doctor Strange for many reasons.
I'm really excited for Tilda Swinton. Is that her name?
Yes.
Yes.
I know that that's been a big issue for some people because she's not Asian.
Stop. Okay.
You worry about the littlest thing. Tilda is she takes everything in her role.
Yes.
She possesses the role.
I understand the whole issue with whitewashing Hollywood. I get it. It is a big thing right now.
Marvel doesn't do that often.
No, Hollywood is doing it.
Yes, it is Hollywood's fault. Yes, I can blame
it. Marvel doesn't do it at, like, specifically in their movies, but they do have an issue with it.
Well, because you had Whedon that was doing a lot of it, and he's pretty big on diversity.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can just style you want. Whedon, I'm a big fan.
I'm not upset at Joss Whedon for anything. I'm upset for how overhyped Joss Whedon is. I'm not saying he isn't talented. I'm not saying he hasn't done some amazing things in his career. But every time you bring up TV or movies, Joss Whedon did this. Joss Whedon did this. Blah, 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 blah. I don't care.
From a woman's standpoint, it's totally different.
The only time I care about directors is when I hear Michael Bay, I immediately sell my ticket to whatever he's directing. Period. When I hear Michael Bay, I'm just like, nope, I'm done.
I'm getting that way with Abrams, but...
J.J. Abrams? Isn't he like the king of lens flare?
Yes.
Yeah, so we have J.J. Flarebrams.
There you go.
And Michael TNT. There you go.
Which sucks, because I'm a big...
What if they co-directed a movie and it was all lens flare and explosions?
Oh my god! And would we see anything except...
And like two lines of dialogue from Megan Fox, just like... I don't like that. Credits.
Megan Fox, not a fan. She's hot, yes. Super
no,
hot.
She's not! No, she's not! What are you talking about?
Let me finish what I'm saying. That is what she's capitalizing on. I think them using her... Well, it's Michael Bay. But I'm a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles fan, and I'm just really upset that she's April.
The only reason I am going to see the second...
It's Turtles is the only reason I'm
saying
it. No,
Stephen Amell. That's it.
It's going to be totally another topic because Arrow playing...
Casey Jones. So excited.
I have mixed feelings.
I did not see the first one. I have refused to because I just... Okay.
It's Turtles. Now, see, we can't...
The only reason I even wanted... Okay, I'm going to...
You didn't grow up on the Turtles like I did.
What are you talking about?
I'm older than you. I was that one's age when Turtles came out.
This one. I'm gonna have a heart attack. I'm gonna drop on the floor and die.
He's gonna have a heart attack because he can't poop because they're so tiny.
Please send me laxatives. My brother needs to poop. Okay, just give me a second. Let me say what I need to do about Turtles.
Okay.
Okay. The only reason I even thought about seeing Turtles was because the guy who played Thad in Blue Mountain State was Raphael. And he was hilarious in Blue Mountain State. But I didn't see it. Just because it looks like a terrible movie. If you haven't seen Blue Mountain State, I think they're either canceled now or the show went off, whatever. But just watch.
It's probably not my thing.
No, it's not. It's college football show.
Not traditional football, so there you go.
It's about a fraternity playing college football.
But it's drama.
No, it's comedy. And it's hilarious.
Yeah, but again, it's not traditional football.
Okay.
We'll go with that. And we are back to Marvel.
Yeah, we're back. We're back. After a slight deviation from our plan, we're back. Because Turtles.
The fool's hat, gone.
Cowabunga.
You see it? We're going to be using it a lot more later on when we get it figured out.
Yeah.
But, yeah. We were talking about Black Panther.
Yes.
Black Panther, not the group. Here I told you, look it up. If you haven't looked it up at this point, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Black Panther's awesome. And the subtleties that they brought in on him... is just enough to get you interested in the movie, but
yes.
They did so well with keeping to the character.
Yes, they did. Yes.
I mean, it was... Even if you haven't read the comics, or even the animation.
Yeah.
It's been an animation.
I wasn't too big on animation.
But it still gives you knowledge.
That's true. I don't do too well for anything with Marvel aside from the Iron Man.
Well, I think I've established Marvel is very good at movies.
I wish they would stop putting so much extra effort into things that people don't care about from them. Marvel, you know that you're great at movies, so stick to your cinematic universe. Stop making these stupid TV shows and these stupid one-shots, because they're terrible.
And
they're
DC...
terrible.
Quit. We have Batman. We have Superman. Bring it on.
Not the movie. We don't care about
I want to see Cyborg. I want to see Aquaman. I am loving Wonder Woman.
Yes.
This Wonder Woman.
Ezra Miller. Segue to Flash for a minute. I'm a mega Flash fan.
Yes.
I swear to God, dude, Ezra Miller, I am counting on you, bro. Do not let me down. The 30 seconds I saw of you talking to Batman and BBS, I was ecstatic about that. Do not let me down.
That was our DC moment.
Yes.
But that... this is what we do. This is us. Sorry. No, not sorry.
Not sorry.
Sorry. It's the whole point. Lost in discussion. We are getting completely lost in our discussion.
Yes.
Of everything that we're
doing. That's why we're here. Because we're going to entertain you. And drop some knowledge bombs! Boom. What? Time to live my life.
That's not what to do!
That's why I knocked down
You're not my mama!
I don't want to be your mama, so I knocked down Cap. This Cap doesn't matter. Hashtag Team Iron Man, hashtag.
Okay, so, Black Panther.
Black Panther.
Spider-Man.
Sorry about that.
We're still learning.
That was my phone. Sorry, okay.
Has people calling!
Spider-Man!
Oh my God, you're calling right now!
Tom Holland, you looked right in the suit and... and for all of you complaining about Spider-Man's eyes, you need to quit. You're messing up. Look at the comics. Yeah, it's a little different. It's a little off, but off is new. When Iron Man came out, it was off and it was new and it was weird. But look at it now! It's become this huge global phenomenon. It's totally chill. It'll be okay. I promise you, man. Tom Holland's gonna blow it out of the water.
I think he is. It's the first Spider-Man.
My favorite part of Spider-Man just being in that movie was, whoa, bro, you have a metal arm? That's so cool!
I know. Everything he was doing during that whole fight at the airport was just... Ant-Man. He and Ant-Man, their commentary.
Yep.
You could just watch that. Yep. You don't need to see the rest of the movie. If you just watch it, just watch the airport scene.
I really think Ant-Man and Spider-Man should just have, like, a movie of their own.
Like, we would be doing nothing but laughing the whole time.
It'd be the first comedy-based superhero movie. It'd be hilarious. You just have Ant-Man.
Deadpool.
Like, oh, Jesus.
Deadpool.
No Spidey Pool. No Spidey Pool. I swear to God, Marvel, if you have a Spidey Pool movie plan, you scrap it now. We're not ready. Not ready for Spidey Pool. I'm not. I can't do it.
Can't do it.
And I won't. I know, I don't want to break her stuff. That's just too far.
I played my toys.
I've seen videos. No, I haven't. I'm just kidding.
No, he hasn't.
I'm not kidding about the midget pictures, though. But I think this is a pretty good time for us to wrap up before we get too lost in things. So like I said, if you have suggestions for what we talk about next, drop it in the comments below. And after the next post, we will see who wins, and we will,
I didn't even give my hashtag, because I don't have a hashtag.
Oh, that's right,
What is my hashtag? Be nice.
Hashtag be nice! There we go!
There you go, let's get that!
If you think Cap won this discussion, you think I won this discussion, then hashtag, just for, you know.
Or you can do hashtag Cap.
Or hashtag Cat versus hashtag Team Iron Man, you know, whatever suits you for the moment.
Everybody, you love hashtags.
Hashtag.
Hashtag.
Hashtag be nice. I hate the sound of scratching, Mark. Well, like I said, guys, this is about time for us to wrap. So, we will have our links for Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram posted towards the side. So, make sure to like, share, subscribe. Comment down below, see those boxes down there, you see those, and the subscribe button, wherever that thing is going to be.
Down there, that's all we know, is it's down there, we'll work on that.
There's a red recording icon.
Will you get off my boots?
I mean, I could just be like, okay. Well, guys, thanks for tuning in. This is Matt.
This is Jen.
You have a good day. Major feels, by the way.